Dear friends, I'm Cardinal Blaise Supich, and I welcome you to this celebration of Midnight Mass for Christmas 2021. There's so much to be thankful for this year. The dedication of our frontline workers and the life-saving vaccines are making it possible for many of us to safely gather with our loved ones again, as long as we take the right precautions. As the pandemic continues, we are once again recording a televised Mass for Christmas morning. It has been prepared so that as many people as possible from our Catholic community, and indeed all people of goodwill, can come together as a virtual community in this holy season. And though our gatherings in person may at times still be limited, there should not be any less joy. Once again, we are proud to partner with Catholic Extension to bring you this Mass. Let's pause for just a moment as they share their greeting this Christmas morning.
Greetings from North Pole, Alaska. I'm on a mission trip here up to Alaska, and what more fitting place could we find than the town of North Pole? But we're standing in front of St. Nicholas Church. And there's a beautiful shrine here to jolly old St. Nicholas. And this beautiful church was established by Catholic Extension many years ago. We're so grateful to all of you, our donors, for all the wonderful ways that you have made places like St. Nicholas possible for people in the poorest regions of the United States. From Alaska all the way down to Puerto Rico. Through your generosity, you have made yourself present. And at this Christmas time, we're so conscious of the great gift that God has given to us and the all-embracing love that He shows us in His Son, Jesus. Thank you again and again for your great Christmas generosity and generosity through all the years. God bless you, Merry Christmas, and have a happy, happy New Year.
And so our Mass is about to begin. So at this time, let us join together in prayer and gratitude. We start with the voices from the music ministries across the Archdiocese who celebrate the good news of the birth of the Christ child this joyous morning.
Fire of war. Bye. The 25th day of December, when ages beyond number had run their course from the creation of the world, when God in the beginning created heaven and earth, and formed man in his own likeness, when century upon century had passed since the Almighty set his bow in the clouds after the great flood, as a sign of covenant and peace. In the 21st century, since Abraham, our father in faith, came out of the Ur of the Chaldees. In the 13th century, since the people of Israel were led by Moses in the Exodus from Egypt. Around the 1,000th year since David was anointed king. In the 65th week of the prophecy of Daniel. In the 194th Olympiad. In the year 752 since the foundation of the city of Rome. In the 42nd year in the reign of Caesar Octavian Augustus, the whole world being at peace, Jesus Christ, eternal God and Son of the eternal Father, desiring to consecrate the world by his most loving presence, was conceived by the Holy Spirit. And when 9 months had passed since his conception, was born of the Virgin Mary in Bethlehem of Judah, and was made man. The Nativity of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to the flesh.
The proclamation of Christmas was proclaimed by our cantor, Stephen Noon. Good morning, and a very blessed and joyful Christmas to everyone. I'm Father Greg Sackowitz, the rector of Holy Name Cathedral. This morning, we celebrate the inbreaking of God into our world. It's no ordinary child whose birth we celebrate. We celebrate the birth of God's only Son, Jesus Christ, into our midst. The processional cross used for this midnight mass celebration was presented to Cardinal Blaise Supich at the Pontifical College Josephinum on the occasion of the Cardinal Supich being named to the College of Cardinals on November 19, 2016 in Rome. Cardinal Supich was the 11th Rector President of the Josephinum, which is located in Columbus, Ohio. Our Master of Ceremonies will be Fathers Mark Smolka and Father Andy Matijevic, associate pastors and co-directors of liturgy here at the cathedral. Our servers for this midnight mass celebration are incense Stephanie McIntyre, cross bearer Garrett Pustai, candle bearers Carmelita Mendoza and Crispina Ojeda Simmons, crozier and mitre bearer Marcel Benedicta. Our deacons for the celebration are Deacon Dave Brunsick and Deacon Jim Norman. And our concelebrants include Father Emmanuel Torres Fuentes, Father Michael Trail, Father Matt O'Donnell, Father Sergio Rivas, Father Michael Blaharski, Father Greg Lorenz, and Father Martin Marulanda. And our principal celebrant is Cardinal Blaise Supich, Archbishop of Chicago, and Chicago's 9th Archbishop. This is Cardinal Supich's 8th Midnight Mass celebration as the Archbishop of Chicago. Cardinal Supich was installed as Chicago's ninth Archbishop on November 18, 2014, here at the Cathedral. Cardinal Supich was elevated to the College of Cardinals by Pope Francis on November 19, 2016, in Rome.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
A blessed Christmas to all who are here this evening and also joining us by television as we come together to celebrate the birth of the Lord. With me today, this evening, is a number of priests who have been with our various communities in the various language groups and the recording of masses so that they could be shown to people on Sunday, especially if they have not been able to return to their churches because of COVID. And so I really want to thank them for their really untiring service to the people of God, and we're so glad that you're all here today. We ask the Lord at the beginning of every Eucharist to be close to us in the depths of our heart where sin may still lie. And let us then be open to that presence, a presence that brings forgiveness, healing, and reconciliation. You are the good shepherd who never leaves a flock intended. Lord, have mercy. You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy. You are the one who forgives our sins as we call upon you in our need. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all of our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. His light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. We now begin the liturgy of the word. In our first reading, proclaimed by, in Spanish, Oscar Herrera.
Lectura del libro de Isaías. El pueblo que caminaba en tinieblas vio una luz grande. Habitaban tierras de sombras y una luz les brilló. Acreciste la alegría, aumentaste el gozo. Se gozan en tu presencia, como gozan al segar, como se alegran al repartirse el botín. Porque la vara del opresor, el yugo de su carga, el bastón de su hombro, los quebrantaste como el día de Madián. Porque la bota que pisa con estrépito y la túnica empapada de sangre serán combustible, pasto del fuego. Porque un niño nos ha nacido, un hijo se nos ha dado. Lleva al hombro el principado y es su nombre, maravilla de consejero, Dios guerrero, Padre perpetuo, príncipe de la paz. Para dilatar el principado con una paz sin límites sobre el trono de David y sobre su reino. Para sostenerlo y consolidarlo con la justicia y el derecho. Desde ahora y por siempre, el celo del Señor lo realizará. Palabra de Dios.
The cantors for Midnight Mass celebration are Catherine Gray Noon and Stephen Noon.
Let the land and all it
comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with justice. He will govern thy peoples with his truth.
Our second reading will be proclaimed in Polish by Elizabeth Seisel-Mukowska.
Czytanie z listu świętego Pawła Apostoła do Tytusa. Umiłowany, ukazała się łaska Boga, która niesie zbawienie wszystkim ludziom i poucza nas, abyśmy, wyrzekwszy się bezbożności i rządz światowych, rozumnie i sprawiedliwie i pobożnie żyli na tym świecie, oczekując błogosławionej nadziei i objawienia się chwały wielkiego Boga i Zbawiciela naszego Jezusa Chrystusa, który wydał samego siebie za nas, aby odkupić nas od wszelkiej nieprawości i oczyścić lud wybrany z siebie na własność, gorliwy w spełnianiu dobrych uczynków. Oto Słowo Boże.
The Holy Gospel, and gospel means good news, will be proclaimed by Deacon Jim Norman.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed,
who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping the night watch over the flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go then to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Our homily will be delivered by Cardinal Blaise Supich, Archbishop of Chicago. This is Cardinal Supich's 8th Midnight Mass celebration in Chicago. Cardinal Supich was the former bishop of Spokane, Washington.
It's good to be with you this evening. It's a pleasure to celebrate this wonderful feast of Christmas, which is so dear to all of our hearts, by coming together, despite the danger of this plague that we're suffering. My prayer for you and your families and all of you who are watching is that soon this will end and we will all remain healthy. This evening, we have the full story of those who received the first news of the birth of Jesus. And in many ways, the church gives us these shepherds as a way of helping us be the ones also who come to adore the Lord, to look for ways in which our own lives can be enhanced by seeing the things that mark the lives of these shepherds. Let me point out three things. The first you should notice is that we're told that they were out in the fields. We use that expression, someone who's out in left field, somebody who is on the margins. And these have been on the margin. They're the people who walk in darkness, the people who live in the shadows in life. We know them all too well in our city, maybe even our own families, the people that seem to have drifted away from our everyday experience and who are out of sight and out of mind. And yet it is to these that the Lord is revealed by the angels, the good news by these angels from on high. It is a reminder that not only should we look for ways in which we bring people out of the shadows, whether they're undocumented immigrants, the poor, people who are suffering from various emotional illnesses, people who are often neglected. But rather, we should also see that they have something to offer us. I was struck reading a quote from Archbishop Victor Fernandez, who wrote about this very theme some time ago. This is how he put it. We can find in the poor some profoundly Christian values, a spontaneous attention to the other, an ability to devote time to others and to go to another's aid without calculating time or sacrifice, while the more educated with a more organized life are unlikely to grant to others time, attention, and sacrifice spontaneously, with joy, and disinterestingly. We know people who live in the shadows, who are poor, who are spontaneous in their generosity. And the shepherds today remind us to be attentive to the value of those people for the life of the world. They have something to teach us, as these shepherds do as well. And maybe even in our own families, if there are people who are living in the shadows, to look for ways in which they are integrated back into the life of our families and in society. The second thing that's quite interesting about these shepherds, even though we hear about Caesar Augustus and Quirinius, the head of Syria, and even Mary and Joseph, we hear their names. We don't hear the names of these shepherds. Tradition has it when the Magi came, we know their names of Melchior, Balthazar, and Caspar. But these shepherds are unnamed. They're anonymous. And it's a reminder to all of us of the many anonymous people in our own family histories, in our own church's history, that have done so many things that have enhanced our life today that maybe we take for granted. Looking at this beautiful cathedral here, all the people who made sacrifices so that this building could be here and stand here for many generations after them. The artisans and all the people who built this building, we don't know their names. And so too in our own families. I always like to tell the story of going on a retreat and hearing a man come forward to give a witness talk, as they said, to a bunch of men who were adult men who were on retreat. And he brought up with him, and he placed on the table next to him, a pair of work boots. They were somewhat muddy and scruffed up, and he put them on the table. And he began to tell the story of how he grew up in a family that was very strapped for cash. His father came back from the Second World War and took a menial job, didn't seem to amount to much at all. He was never proud of his dad because he really didn't seem to advance, and he was going to make his life different. And so he went to a good school, went to college, and finally one day came home and said that he had landed a great job out of the blue. And he advanced himself in this global conglomerate, this wonderful worldwide company, and moved up in the ranks. Well, the father died. And even though he was not too close to his father because he wasn't very proud of him, he still mourned his loss. And as they were at the funeral home, in walked in the CEO of this huge international conglomerate that he worked for. He had never met him before, but he recognized him. Oh, he said, "I'm so touched that you came here. I'm so glad that you're with us here in this moment." And he said, "Oh," the man said, "are you related to the deceased, to Jack?" "Oh yes," he said, "he's my father." And then the CEO said, "Oh, so you're the son." And then he told the story of how Jack, his father, during the Second World War, saved his life. He pulled him out of harm's way. And he always told him, "Jack, if there's anything I can ever do for you, let me know." Jack never asked for a favor. They exchanged Christmas cards and called on the phone once in a while. Never asked a thing until one day he called him and said, "Can you give my son a job?"
Well, that son realized that at that moment, he owed all of his success to his father's intervention with that CEO. And then he pointed to the boots that he had brought up and said, you know, I always thought I pulled myself up by my bootstraps, but I forgot that somebody gave me the boots. How true that is for all of us. There are people who have done so much for us who are in the shadows that we should be thankful for of God's providence, like these shepherds who are unnamed. And finally, it's interesting to note that these shepherds leave the scene just like the angels who announced the good news. They left glorifying God, we're told, just like the angels did. They are, in many ways, the first evangelizers. And it is, I think, a moment for us to reflect on how, especially in this moment of Renew My Church, but also as the Pope has called the church to approach our life in a synodal way, of how we're taking seriously how we too need to evangelize. I've often said that perhaps the patron saint of all Catholics should be Calvin Coolidge. You know, Calvin Coolidge, they said you couldn't get three words out of him. He was fishing one week up in South Dakota, the story goes, and a lady came up to him and says, I bet my husband $10 that I could get you to say three words. He simply looked at her and said, you lose. Sometimes we're silent as that way as well about our faith. And my invitation to you as you hear the story of the shepherds, as you leave here today from the Christmas celebration, is to look for ways in which you tell your children and grandchildren of why Christmas means something to you, why your faith means something to you, of how your faith has got you through some difficult times. That's where real evangelization begins to take place. When we tell our story of salvation, like these shepherds tell the story to Mary and Joseph, and she treasures all these things in her heart. And so think of Our Lady this day as you tell your story to your children and grandchildren, that it will give Mary another story to treasure in her heart. And so today, as we celebrate this Christmas feast, the angels have a lot to tell us, to make sure that we're open to those who are marginalized and in the shadows, for they have so much to offer us. To make sure as well that we're thankful to God for all the people who are unknown, who made a difference in our life. And finally, to take up the task of evangelizing like these shepherds do, so that we will leave here just as they did, just as the angels did, filled with awe and wonder, glorifying God for all that he has done for us. Merry Christmas. Stand with me now as we profess the one faith that binds us together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, life from life, true God. Thank you. Sisters and brothers, God's boundless generosity is manifest in giving us his only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And now as we celebrate his birth from the Blessed Virgin Mary, we bring our needs and the needs of the entire world to the Lord with confidence in his loving and generous response.
For the Church of God throughout the world and in the Archdiocese of Chicago, that together with Pope Francis and Cardinal Supich, we may give effective witness to Jesus, the Word made flesh, who makes all brothers and sisters to each other.
Por el mundo, nuestra nación y por nuestra ciudad, para que el Príncipe de la Paz rompa la violencia y la opresión y reine la reconciliación y armonía entre nosotros los ciudadanos.
Módlme sem za całą ludkość, która cierpi w wyniku szerzącej się epidemii, za chorych i za tych, którzy ofiarnie noszą im pomoc, aby szczególnie w czasie tych świąt Pan obdarzył ich zdrowiem i potrzebnymi łaskami.
Para sa ating mga pinuno, opisyal at kinatawan ng ating pambansa, estado at lungsod, naway si Jesus na siyang karunungan at makapangyarihan ng Diyos ang magbibigay sa kanila ng kaunawaan at lakas ng loob na magtatag ng isang makatarungan at patas na lipunan upang magpahalagahan at ingatan ang lahat ng buhay at upang mapaglingkuran ang pangangailangan ng mga mahihina sa atin.
For all those who ensure our safety and security, police officers, firefighters, emergency medical personnel, and members of the military, especially those separated from family and friends at this time, that Jesus, born to shepherd his people, would lead, guide, and direct all those who protect us.
Hear us, O Lord, send
per tutti i defunti, specialmente per coloro che abbiamo perso quest'anno e per i loro cari che soffrono per la loro dipartita. Che Gesù, vittorioso sul peccato e la morte, ci accompagni attraverso la valle di oscurità nel suo regno di luce.
We pray to the Lord.
Hear us, O Lord, Señor, escúchanos. Magnificus, oímos, dignir mortami.
In the birth of your only begotten Son, O Lord, you have opened for us a way to eternal life. Hear and answer the prayers of your people, who rejoice and know that he has come among us to be our Savior and our light, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Our prayers of the faithful were led by, in English, Michelle Sotak and Valerie Jennings. In Spanish, Sister Maria Elia Lacona Vargas. Polish, Chester Jukala. Tagalog, George Pineda. Italian, Charlene Sobey. The gifts of bread and wine, simple gifts, gifts that really symbolize us. Bread and wine symbolize all believers, for we are the body of Christ. We ask the Lord to make us holy, to change us too. Because of COVID-19, the gifts of bread and wine will not be led by gift bearers. The gifts of bread and wine have already been placed upon the holy altar. At today's offertory, please keep in mind the good works of Catholic Extension, whose mission connects poor and remote Catholic communities with financial support, educational partnerships, and infrastructure. Make your donation at catholicextension.org/bless. Once again, catholicextension.org/bless. You can text the word BLESS to 50155. Again, texting it, BLESS to 50155. Thank you for your generosity.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours
will be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels, archangels, thrones, and dominions, with all the hosts, the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Fount of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, my brother bishops, the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life.
and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
In the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger, we have Emmanuel, God with us. Fear is useless because God, on his Bethlehem night, has taken on all that frightens us. The birth of Jesus is the inbreaking of God into our world, into our lives. Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The simple gifts of bread and wine have been transformed in the body and blood of Christ. The Lord bends to touch us first, and we respond to the Lord's love and the gift of himself. In turn, we are challenged to love this world back into life, and like Christ, to all our sisters and brothers. Not an easy task in today's world. As St. Augustine once said, we are challenged to become what we have received. Eucharist exists not only to change bread and wine, but also to change us. The cathedral is beautifully decorated this Christmas. The marvelous work by our environment team, led by Donna Krzyzewski, Ron Birch, Darren Lanowitz, and Diane Knuckles. All the ushers and greeters are parishioners of Holy Name Cathedral. Our music and liturgy this night has been absolutely splendid, thanks to our director of music at Holy Name Cathedral, David Jonas. Our vocal quartet has been Catherine Gray Noon, Stephen Noon, Daniel Riley, Elizabeth Osolovich. And Metropolis Chamber Orchestra, with Jerry Lou Zeik as the director. A special thanks to Father Mark Smolka, our director of liturgy, and Father Andy Matijevic, assistant director of liturgy. Special thanks to Michelle Peltier, director of liturgical services and special events. Special thanks also to Todd Williamson, the director, and Wendy Barton Silhavy, the Office of Divine Worship here in Chicago. Lastly, thank you to the Office of Radio and Television, the Archdiocese of Chicago, Vince Gerasoli, the director, Michael May, Brian Brock, Javier Garcia, assisted by Susan Carlson and Patrick Hartney. And our sacristan this evening has been Nick Young.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we, who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity, may, through an honorable way of life, become worthy of union with Him who lives and reigns forever and ever. These surely have been challenging times for all of us, and I am edified, as I know my pastors are, by the wonderful support that they have received from the people of God throughout this year, especially as the pandemic continues. Some of them have asked to be able to say things more personally to you in different languages. And so a group of our pastors have come together to offer their thanks in various languages to let you all know how much they appreciate what you have done for them.
As the priest prepares the chalice at the altar, he says a beautiful prayer quietly into himself. He says, "By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity." This Christmas, we celebrate the one who humbled himself to share in our humanity so we could share in his divinity. We can only say thank you before such a great mystery. And our gratitude extends out from there to our family and friends, to those who care for us along the way of life, and to you who have supported and sustained the mission and ministry of the church in these challenging times. May God continue to bless all of us in this holy season of his son's birth.
Mientras el sacerdote prepara el cáliz en el altar, dice una hermosa oración en voz baja para sí mismo. Él dice, por el misterio de esta agua y este vino, haz que compartamos la divinidad de quien se dignó participar en nuestra humanidad. Esta Navidad celebremos al que se humilló para participar de nuestra humanidad, para que nosotros pudiéramos participar en su divinidad. Solamente podemos dar gracias ante tan gran misterio. Y nuestra gratitud se extiende desde allí a nuestra familia y amigos, aquellos que cuidan de nosotros a lo largo del camino de la vida. Y a ustedes que han apoyado y sostenido la misión y el ministerio de la Iglesia en tiempos difíciles. Que Dios continúe bendiciéndonos a todos nosotros en esta temporada santa del nacimiento de su Hijo.
Podczas sprawowania Eucharystii, zanim kapłan weźmie do ręki kielich, wypowiada po cichu piękną modlitwę, mówi: Przez to misterium wody i wina daj nam, Boże, udział w bóstwie Chrystusa, który przyjął nasze człowieczeństwo. Podczas tych świąt Bożego Narodzenia czcimy i wysławiamy Boga, który uniżył samego siebie, by mieć udział w naszym człowieczeństwie, abyśmy my sami mogli mieć udział w Jego bóstwie. W obliczu tak wielkiej tajemnicy wiary możemy jedynie dziękować. To właśnie stąd nasza wdzięczność rozlewa się na naszą rodzinę i przyjaciół, na tych, którzy troszczą się o nas na drodze naszego życia i na was, którzy w tych trudnych czasach wspieracie i podtrzymujecie posługę duszpasterską Kościoła. Niech Bóg nam wszystkim błogosławi i obdarza potrzebnymi łaskami w tym świętym okresie narodzin swego Syna. Wesołych świąt Bożego Narodzenia.
诸内的弟兄姊妹们好，在这神圣的圣诞佳节，从圣德里教堂向诸位致以最温暖的问候。圣诞节普世同庆，耶稣屈尊就被降生成人，取得人性。 好使我们也能分享基督的天主性，这是信德的奥迹，也是爱的奥迹。所以，在这特别而神圣的时刻，我们内心无比感恩，感谢爱我们的天主、家人和朋友，感谢在生活中关心我们的人，以及所有为教会无私奉献的人。 在这特别而神圣的时刻，我们也向大家献上我们最美好的祝福，祝大家圣诞平安，健康喜乐，祝恩满意。
And on behalf of all of our pastors throughout the Archdiocese, I thank all of you for your support of them as they have looked for ways to keep our parish communities vibrant and together. The televised masses as well that we have done here in Chicago have had that same aim, to make sure that we stay together in this very difficult moment of the pandemic. Let us continue to pray for each other. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
It is no ordinary child whose birth we celebrate today. It's the birth of God becoming man. Jesus loves us so much, he became one like us, gave his life for us, a love which lasts forever. For Christmas is a celebration of life. Welcome Jesus at Christmas time, not in a cold manger of our heart, but warm with love for each other. Humanists merely admire the baby. Shepherds and kings adore the incarnate God. Unbelievers rock the cradle. Believers let the cradle rock the world. He comes with silence, faith, and awe. Midnight Mass from Holman Cathedral was brought to you by Chicago-based Catholic Extension, working to build vibrant Catholic faith communities in the poorest regions of our country. Please visit CatholicExtension.org to learn how you can, too, walk with God's people to help share God's love. Again, Catholic Extension. christmaspeace.org. And please remember, if we don't have Christmas in our heart, we will never find it under the tree. From all of us here at Holy Name Cathedral, we want to wish you and your loved ones a very blessed and joyous Christmas. You always know God's wonder, feel His warmth, and share His love. May God bless all of us. I'm Father Greg Sackowitz, Rector of Holy Name Cathedral.
Inspiration, two powerful forces which, when brought together, can move us toward the realization of Pope Francis's vision for our Catholic Church to be more missionary. For over 100 years, the mission of Catholic Extension has been to build up the Catholic Church in the poorest communities of the United States.
Catholic Extension has been called the best kept secret in the Catholic Church. We are a fundraising organization that serves over 90 U.S. dioceses, from the farthest reaches of Alaska to the Gulf Coast of Florida. We call these mission dioceses, where economic resources are scarce, but the people are rich in faith. Our mission has always been to make the Catholic Church accessible to everyone, especially the poor, the marginalized, and those on the peripheries. We firmly believe in the power of faith to transform lives and to help people realize that they are more than their circumstances. Since its founding in 1905, Catholic Extension, through the generosity of our donors, has awarded more than $1.2 billion in support of people, ministries, and infrastructure. We've built thousands of churches across the country and fill the gas tanks of priests who drive hundreds of miles each week to bring the Eucharist to Catholic communities in remote areas. We promote vocations by supporting the education of seminarians, the formation of deacons, and the salaries of women religious. We give Catholic schools the tools to thrive, and we support religious education programs and catechists. We train young adult leaders, campus ministers, and youth ministers who are empowering the next generation of the Catholic Church. We fund women religious and Hispanic lay leaders who are reaching out to diverse and growing populations within the Church. We provide a hopeful presence in underprivileged areas in the United States through ministries to Native Americans, migrant workers, and impoverished communities. But we can't do any of this without your support. As fellow Catholics, we are called to be the people of God. It is our responsibility to help these communities feel God's life-giving love by participating in our shared faith. These communities are the future of our church, and these are the places where our church is at its most inspiring. It's no secret, the Catholic faith has the power to transform lives and communities. Join Catholic Extension in our mission to build faith, inspire hope, and ignite change. Together, we can strengthen the future of the Catholic Church in America.
We want to thank each and every one of you for joining us this morning. Again, we wish you all the joy of the season, full of the promise that comes with the birth of our Savior. Merry Christmas.